Hello to all of you. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, and even good night. It is the 3rd of April and our summary meeting. Let's do our regular sound check. If you can hear and see me well, if everything is fine, we can start. I see your responses. Thank you. And as I told you, this is the summary webinar and we will discuss different topics. Therefore, let's get started. Full of attention to our speakers and to cover all our agenda. And let's discuss what we reached and our achievements throughout the previous month. Those of you who may not know me, my name is Lina Valeria Ravelo Bermudes. I am the entrepreneur and I'm so proud to be from Colombia. I am a public accountant by my background. The Evorich Consumer Community Affiliate Program Manager. I'm also a student of the private invest of the Academy of Private Investor, member of the local Evorich Leadership Council in Colombia, and the founder of the Evorich Leadership School. Thank you for these opportunities for all us meeting here. Next slide, please. And now let's have a look at our program for today. We have 7 important items on it. The first one is the last month's events in March and the latest news of the company, the most important news of the company. The second one is the financial department's monthly report and the Cryptounit report, the monthly report of the global UnitPay project, followed up by some information from the Association Generals of the World for Peace, item 6. The project of Genius of Finance, and finally, the monthly report of EduCafe project. And we will start backed by this agenda. As always, I want to thank all our interpreters because thanks to them, we can understand and know the latest news of the company. So, the first point on the agenda is main events and company's latest news. Here we will discuss what has happened and the updates of the previous month and the most important news, the latest news. Let us remember the day important for Unitex when on the 20th of March, 2 p.m. Moscow time, we all received this incredible news that we can start trading at Unitex exchange. It was stunning. And we were learning a lot in the course of our trading at Unitex. We also got a lot of recommendations of how to top up our accounts in the exchange. And there are 2 ways, by bank card in USD or with cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, Ethereum, and EOS. And then you can exchange your money into the stablecoin USDU and buy our CIU token. And it was important to remember that the initial price of one CIU was 20 cents. And in prospect, in the future, within 1 year, it may reach $10 or even more. And we have heard many times from our CEO about this. And this price change could change many people's lives. Therefore, let's be conscientious when you want to sell your CIU's token. Unitex is an exchange, and not everyone may have been verified, and not everyone may understand how it operates, but we don't need rush. We don't need you to be in a hurry. For instance, in Latin America, we need a passport to go through verification, as this is an international document that is needed for this process. There was a surprise, and that is an article published at the website km.ru, portal website. This is a newspaper that includes the latest news in Russia and not only. And our CEO presented, the Academy of Private Investor told the whole world what we are doing and which benefits a graduate of the Academy of Private Investor gets. And we always remember that Andrey Khovratov always says that you'd better make mistakes when you play a game rather than in real life. Therefore, Andrey Khovratov is our financial guru, shared how and where to get updated, effective financial and investment education, even staying at home during the crisis time. And we should understand that what we share is new opportunities. And every time we open new towns, new countries, and therefore financial education is really important and significant. And Andrey Khovratov also in his article says that it's hard to recall that in kindergarten, school, or college, someone taught us how to take care of our finances, create passive sources of income, or create a good business. And the key message is the financial education, financial literacy is what we all need in our lives. And we should always get new knowledge. And the article and its main idea is that we should be well aware of what we are doing in the world of finances. Another important piece of news is the guide on Cryptounit blockchain, crypto wallet. You can find it in Cryptounit back office. And this guide is very easy to read, user-friendly, I would say. And Maria Antonenko was supporting this guide creation. There were trainings with the details of how to create our wallets in line with all the recommendations and suggestions by Maria. So we should be very careful to protect, to store safe our seed phrase. And today this guide is available, and I believe that many partners have already created their wallets on the Cryptounit blockchain, and this is a reality. And our crypto wallet is an application created for storing and transferring Cryptounit blockchain tokens. And this wallet enables us to encrypt all our assets. We have staking plans, and you can start the process we were looking forward to. And all this is possible due to the hard work done by our company. And this working group that developed this project. And in March, an important part was the creation of our crypto wallets, so that we created, we learned how to create them properly, and then based on this, we could stake our CIUs. And in April, there is a lot to expect as well. And one more important piece of news, and the event we were preparing hard for, is our Summit 21 on the 30th of March. It's not a simple gathering and a webinar. This is a full-scale event. And you know that there were a lot of countries participating, and we were really honored. I mean, Latin American region. And taking this opportunity, I'd like to express my gratitude, as we are really proud and we worked hard here in our region and still work hard. And thank you very much for your seeing our results, our performance, and the way we develop here in Latin America. And Evorich Summit is the event where we could share the statistics, the information, the way we evolved. And we believe that, so it was the second anniversary of the Cryptounit program. But do you know what to expect in the future? In 2 years, we achieved so much, and I could not even imagine what to expect in the years to come. It was incredible. It was awesome. We were so happy, so excited. And you know, we shared every happy moment in this company, and it was from the bottom of our hearts. And we will continue celebrating our achievements at the global level of our community that changes people's lives. What else we witnessed in March? New terms of withdrawal of bonuses from our back office. It's important to understand why we have these changes. The senior management of the company is interested so that every partner has legal income receipt with no problems in their relevant countries. It means that we must act in the legal field in a transparent way, and we meet and are compliant with the laws in all the countries. Therefore, you should meet all the tax laws and regulatory acts in your countries. Therefore, in the short run, the withdrawal of bonuses will be accessible only to those partners who are registered as individual entrepreneurs or self-employed people. Please know this. And then the following methods of withdrawal will be available. What I'm going to tell you depends on the country of your stay. If it is through the API back office, then it could be bank transfer, and it is available for such countries as Russia, Belarus, Kazakhstan, India, Australia, New Zealand, United States, Italy, Emirates, Oman and Kuwait. And if you make your withdrawal through the Evorich back office, then you can do it through the Global Unit Pay system, and it is available to any country. So those people who are doing this through the API back office, so the countries are unlisted, and if you haven't verified your account in Global Unit Pay, please do it, as it is very important. And this is what actually the company strives for, so that we in a legal way declare all our incomes in any country from the cooperation with the company. We develop the Evorich partnership, and therefore we should behave transparently. and therefore there are a lot of webinars, trainings on this. And once again, if you are not in the list of countries who cannot withdraw through the API back office, you can do it easily through the Evorich back office. And there is another piece of news from the Academy of Private Investor, a new way to top up your account. And this is another important piece of news. To top up an account in the Academy of Private Investor, you can use Cash Plus payment system by means of a bank transfer in the UK in pound sterling, bank transfers worldwide, and the currency here is euro, and the bank transfer for countries you can find in this list. They are enumerated here. And for these countries, the currency is euro and the transaction time is 3-5 days. And it is also important for those countries that are not a part of these three groups, then please recall the previous slide of how you can top up your accounts. Top up the account and withdraw the bonuses. And we've recalled all the important pieces of news in March. And now let's move to the next part of our today's webinar, and that is the monthly report of the financial department. And this information will be provided by our well-beloved partner, Harin Arun. This is the first chance I can introduce him, and I'm so privileged and honored to do it. And I always know that the sincerity of Harin and the way he presents this difficult information to us in an easy language, it's something incredible. And we know that Harin is one of the leaders of our companies. Meanwhile, he is the deputy head of the investment department of Evorich, representative of the council, leadership council, Evorich affiliate program executive board. He is a certified master. He is a certified coach of Master Profi and Genius of Finance and member of the Association Generals of the World for Peace, professional investor, entrepreneur, speaker. Harin, I'm really privileged to introduce you and pass the floor to you.
Hello, everyone. If you can hear me, if you can see me, and you're absolutely excited to be here again, then please put the biggest number you can find on the chat for me. Amazing. Valeria, it's an absolute pleasure to be introduced by you again. It was amazing to see the Latin American community on the Evorich Summit just less than a week ago. So Valeria, thank you for your amazing, warm welcome. I'm absolutely excited to be here again. So guys, how are you doing? How is everyone doing? How is your Saturday going? And before we get into the financial report, let's hear some feedback about the Evorich Summit 21. What did you guys feel? What did you guys felt about it? And also just put in one word or maybe a short sentence of how you felt about the whole thing was presented to you guys. All right. If we can have the next slide, in every single room, there would be amazing. It's a pleasure again. Again, thanks, Valentin, for putting together this wonderful slide. Everyone, please do put in a message of, get well soon for Valentin. I hope he comes back to us, with being the healthy Valentin that we know. All right. So guys, for the top 10 registration at the 10th spot, we see Vietnam at 171 registrations. In the 9th spot, we have India at 688 registrations. At the 8th spot, we have Italy. Again, congratulations, Italy. 8th spot, 338 registrations. Peru on the seventh spot at 388 registrations. And number six, USA, 315 registrations. All of you might be looking at this list and thinking, you know what? Everything is a negative, but I still think it is a big win. And we had a busy month. We had a lot of changes. We had the blockchain to get ready for and the Unitex exchange to get ready for. So everyone is a little bit one step behind, but doesn't matter. All right. I think everything will get back in track very, very soon. So we have on the sixth spot at USA at 315 registrations. On the fifth spot, Netherlands, congratulations again at 113 registrations. Colombia, well done. It was an absolute excitement for the Colombian community, I think, in the last week at 402 registrations for the month. I think you guys will do really well very, very soon anyway. And the third spot, we have Russia at 151 registrations. And number two, Spain at 157 and winning this whole month's registration tally is Ecuador at 194 registrations. It might look low, but doesn't matter. Let's celebrate the new members that are coming to our into our company and our organization, and the registrations will follow. I think we have to build up on these numbers, guys, but I think everyone in the top 10 registration list, congratulations for being on this list. And let's plan and make the next month even bigger, much more excitement and exciting for every single one of us. If you can have the next slide, let's see how well we did on the sales growth for every single country. If we have the next slide, amazing, guys. So here go, the top 10 volume, it's on negative, but I don't like to focus on the negative, because end of the day, the growth that we're having is still amazing. It's still tremendous effort from every single one of us. So on the 10th spot, we have Russia at $195,000 and $763. It's a 39% negative growth, but doesn't matter. All right. On the 9th spot, we have Oman. Congratulations. I think less than 6 months ago, I saw Oman almost breaking the $1 million mark. Well, I think Oman will do really well very soon at $207,000, negative 41%. But hey, doesn't matter. Let's focus on the growth. Let's focus on how to bring back, how to get every single one of the people excited to go further. On the 8th spot, we have Colombia at $332,000 and Peru, another Latin American community at $336,000, not far apart. Again, well done, Peru and Colombia. You guys are absolutely smashing it. Netherlands, you had a slight drop back, but doesn't matter. At $379,000, Netherlands, well done again for making it in the top 10 volume chart. Vietnam, fifth spot, congratulations. At $421,000 collection. Again, a slight drop, almost by half, but doesn't matter. I know every single one of you will do really well. On the fourth spot, Australia. Last month, we had a chat about this, but Australia has dropped to the fourth spot. Again, Australia, take it as a challenge. Let's make it back on the top three again at $605,000 collection. Wonderful, wonderful job, Australia. At third spot, this is a bit of surprising for every single one of you. You know, the unbeatable giant for almost more than 12 months has finally got to the third spot, but nonetheless, India, congratulations for still maintaining the third spot and very close to the $1 million mark at $815,000. India, congratulations. Looking forward for you to be number one again, and all Indian partners, looking forward for your tremendous effort. At second place, Italy. This is very surprising. We saw them at the bottom of the list 12 months ago, and look at them in the second place right now. Very, very close to the $1 million mark and $932,000 turnover. And of course, drum rolls, everyone. Let's give USA the well-deserved respect and congratulations. Team USA, just do me a favor, put USA as many as number of times you can in the chat box. Let's explode this and let's actually show our genuine congratulations to USA. USA, well done at $1.1 million turnover and finally reaching the first spot in the top 10 volume chart for our organization for the month of March. Congratulations, USA. My heartfelt congratulations. And your partners, you're a true testament to our organization in terms of growth and also hard work. If we can have the next slide in every single room, let's look at the summary of how did we go up to the month of March. It's a little bit of error here, but doesn't matter. We're looking at 1.5, just under 1.6 million registered users. We have 666,000 clients and 834,000 partners at 64,000 agents in our organization. The number has tremendously increased from the promotions that we had last month. Consultants, managers, and leader managers in our company has increased slightly as well. We have 15,195 consultants in our organization, 4,323 managers and 1,361 leader managers. And this is where now it gets to a little bit of elite club in our company. The top managers, we have 432 of them. Vice presidents, we have 160 vice presidents and 73 presidents. Up to now, the sales amount has been $238 million. And we have purchased up to assets from $91 million. And right now, guys, the amount that we have paid out on loyalty programs and profi bonuses is $23 million as loyalty programs and $2.5 million in terms of profi bonus. Now, before we wrap up my session, before we welcome the wonderful person that's going to speak next, I just want to let you guys know this is a bit of motivation for every single one of us and everyone. If you're ready to hear this, please put one on the chat. Amazing, amazing, amazing. So guys, I just wanted to tell you, success that we have in our company is actually a compound effect. I spoke about this on our Evorich Summit just under a week ago. If I give you one penny that doubles every single day for the next 30 days, or I give you $1 million right now, which one would you choose? Let's see it on the chat. Perfect. A lot of you are going for the penny. But let's say you picked the $1 million. Actually, let's change it a bit. Let's make it $3 million. Okay. And let's forward our lifestyle a little bit. For the person who picked $3 million, immediately they would be enjoying lifestyle. But for the person who picked one penny, in the fifth day, it's merely 16 cents. On the 10th day, it's merely $5. But somebody who picked the $3 million at the 10th day, they would be enjoying the life. You're probably hearing parties and they're probably having five different cars in front of them purchased. But the one penny doesn't show its real effect until the 30th day. And if you consistently do that, then you will see a compound effect. Compound interest, compound effect is the eighth wonder of this world. And why am I saying that? Every single day, the small choices that we make, the exact same choices that we make, just like the penny that doubles every single day, one day the effect of it is going to be amazing. It's going to be big. It's going to be like a tsunami. All right. A lot of people might be asking, you know, I'm doing the exact same thing. I'm putting in my effort, but the success, it's not something that happens in a day. Success will be tremendous. It'll probably be in the next 10 years, 15 years, 20 years until you see the effect. Just like that in our organization, every single one person's effort, a small piece of choice, a small piece of effort, a small piece of decision that we make in our organization is a quantum compound effect in our organization. And I just want to leave you guys with this one information. There's two types of pain, guys. One of it is pain of discipline, and the second one is pain of regret. A lot of us are thinking, what is this pain of discipline and pain of regret? Very simple, guys. The pain of discipline, it could be, you know, waking up and going for a jog or doing a small routine or reading a book or getting into a meeting, picking up a phone call and speaking to somebody, organizing a rendezvous or even something to do with your business. And a lot of people like us are pretty anxious to do that sometimes. And the pain of discipline sometimes is, it was said by Jim Rohn once in the book, pain of discipline actually weighs ounces, but pain of regret actually weighs tons. The pain of regret, I'm talking about death of somebody, divorce, financial loss, bankruptcy. A lot of things like, you know, regrets that in your life that you never can buy back. So ask yourself, guys, do you guys want the pain of discipline or the pain of regret? So with that, I'm leaving you guys with a bit of a motivation. You know, think about it. Only you can answer. Only you can answer which pain you want to go with. And are you ready to make the small choices to turn into a compound effect? So with that, stay classy, everyone. And handing back to Valeria. Thank you. Bye.
Wow, thank you very much, Harin. Thanks a lot for the information you shared with us. Before we continue and move on to the third part of the webinar, I'd like to congratulate our partners from Ecuador, the first place in registrations. This is an important part of the process. Today, they are number first in registrations. Tomorrow, they're number one in sales. So let's work together to achieve what brings us to success. And my congratulations to the United States for being number one. So you work really hard and it impacts and affects our results. And all those countries that are in top 10, my congratulations. When we work as a team, this is when we get large results. My love and my congratulations to Ecuador, Peru, the United States, Italy, and all the countries in top 10. Well, and after these emotions, positive emotions, let's move on to the third part of our webinar. I like and adore listening to our next speaker. Please change the slide, because this topic of blockchain, our Cryptounit program, keeps our attention as we together live through this process, because otherwise we won't achieve the results we do. But you know, being a part of this process with the support and guidance by the company, it's worth a lot. And now, please welcome our beloved, our adored, our dear Maria Antonenko. Maria is the one who is always ready every Thursday with all its patience to tell us the important news. And we feel this professionalism, this feeling of co-ownership, and thanks to her involvement in this process, all the people around the globe have this relevant information. Maria is the head of the blockchain implementation department. She is a financial specialist with 20 years of experience. She is a personal and corporate finance management expert, Master Profi certified coach, Genius of Finance training leader, vice president under the Consumer Community Affiliate Program of Evorich. And in this particular case, I'd like to tell you that she is my mentor, my coach, in the area of blockchain, because before I've never studied this technology. And you know, thanks to her, I managed to understand it quite easily. And I felt that I'm supported, not only me, but all the other members of our community. She is a very strong woman. Maria, the floor is yours. Thank you very much for this introduction. This is our sound check. Please tell me if you can see and hear me well. Next slide, please. The previous month of March was very busy. We started registration at the exchange and moved to the blockchain. And to date, at the exchange, these figures are a bit outdated. 24,000 people registered at the exchange, whereas today we have over 35,000 people. The figure is outdated because the slides are prepared in advance, and over 7,000 people are in the process of verification, and there are another 5,380 people waiting for their verification. And over 11,000 people who did not submit documents for a verification. And altogether, 743 people were denied their verification. Over 700 letters were sent to these people for the repeat verification with the request to submit new documents. And about 140 people were fully denied, as these people had or have the same names and last names with politicians, either deputies, parliamentarians, or some other judges in the country. So public servants. And public servants may not trade at the exchange. Therefore, about 140 people were denied, and we sent their documents to the department, as the exchange is doing the licensing activities under the laws of Estonia. And in Estonia, there is the police department on cyber affairs, cryptocurrencies, and there is the regulation. If we believe that in our idea, in our opinion, a person is a public servant, and he may not trade, but he's already registered, whereas in this case, 140 people were sent, their documents were sent to the police department, and they will approve or confirm whether we can let them in to the exchange or 100% denial, refusal. And we expect the response from this police department within 4 business days. And if no denial is given, then even these people who are public servants may trade in the exchange. There is 1 month of those waiting. So we also had for this purpose some trainings. 8 people were trained for a certificate of a verifier. And starting from Monday, additional people with this certificate will be included into the process of the verification at the exchange. And I believe that next week, this queue of 5,000 people who wait for verification, this process will be speed up. Next slide, please. So most CIU transactions are made in the crypto wallet. This is a bit outdated slide, and there was no staking of CIU for CIU, and there were only 133,000, and 1.8 billion was for UNTB. Whereas on the 25th of March, when we activated staking program CIU for CIU, many partners staked for UNTB, and over 1 billion CIU was staked for CIU. And it's true that many people didn't manage to do it. Actually, I didn't expect personally that this stake in CIU for CIU will be over in 5 hours. So it was opened, and by 7 p.m. Moscow time, it was seized. It was complete. 3 billion CIU booked for the stake in CIU for CIU ran out very quickly for 5 hours, and that is done. And many people started writing that they failed to do it. Some people unstake their CIUs after 2 p.m., but we actually warned you that there was the change of the unstaking for UNTB. The withdrawal could last up to 72 hours. People were greedy, I believe, and they waited for the last moment, 2 p.m. They staked for UNTB, and as soon as they saw staking program CIU for CIU, they actually pressed the button unstake and had to wait 72 hours for their CIUs to be in balance, whereas those people who did it on the 25th, and in case you don't see your tokens in the balance, please do refresh frozen and refresh balance. If you unstake on the 25th of March and you still don't see your tokens on the balance, so any transaction is updated by this button refresh. Refresh frozen and refresh balance. And if you cannot unstake for UNTB, if you say that 72 hours passed, but tokens are still not in your balance, then you need to clean cache in your browser. You still see the outdated picture, and you need to delete cookies, cache files, or go to your wallet from a different browser. And then your unstaking, in case 72 hours has passed, you will see it in your balance if you press the button refresh frozen and refresh balances. It's important to remember, if you've done it on your own, please help and tell your partners how to do it, to clean cache cookies and update by pressing these buttons, refresh frozen and refresh balance. Next slide, please. Yes, on the 20th of March, we started trading at the Unitex exchange, and the first days of trading suggested the following results. Many partners make mistakes because before they had no experience of trading in any exchange, and in the first days of trading, there was the price limit of 20 cents, and many people managed to buy or sell if they wanted to stake CIU for CIU, but there are disappointed partners who say that they had no wallet in my crypto unit back office, and they bought tokens at the exchange and didn't know where to withdraw them to. Whereas in the news on the 22nd of March, we actually wrote that there are people from outside, and you can go to our blockchain, press the button create, and you don't need to wait for the wallet in the back office of UGPay Group. If you had no wallet in my crypto unit back office, you can start it from scratch. If you have these wallets, then you don't need the new one. If you want to split, for instance, you have a lot of unblocked CIUs and you want to distribute them or to sell them, not to sell, to give them as a gift. then start from scratch, press the button create, and today to create a wallet for the partners from outside, you need at least 249 UNTB tokens. This is the price of our resource of RAM memory, so that you can create a wallet and you can ask someone you know to send 250, 249. So when you create the wallet, you will see this amount. These tokens will be sent to the account called Creator, C-R-U-A-C. You send UNTB to the account of the Creator, Creator, C-R-U-A-C, and you must indicate the memo. Memo is the name of the new wallet. For the partners from outside, for new wallets, they can select the name of their wallets. I did the testing. I made a test of one wallet, created one wallet, and called it Crypto Mom 1-1, as many partners call me Crypto Mom. And you can select any nickname for your wallet you like. But the only exception is that it should be in Latin letters, small letters, and figures from 1 to 5. You, in the name of your wallet, if you do it on your own, you cannot use 0, 6, 7, 8, 9. Only figures from 1 to 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and letters could be used. So you can make 12 symbols to make up your wallet. I know that many people like 7s, 8s, because these are magical symbols and signs of wealth. But EOS blockchain does not accept wallets with the names that include letters over 5. So only one from 1 to 5. You may have a short name, for instance, Crypto Boss, and you need another figures to make up a name of 12 symbols, either letters before this name or after the name, and create the name of the wallet you like. If this wallet is already registered by someone, then the system, blockchain system, will not allow you to select it. It will show an error. You need to replace the figures and then it will be created. And it is desirable that you send UNTB tokens to the balance of the new wallet within 30 minutes, 1 hour maximum, as this name of the account could be occupied by someone. You generate a wallet, the blockchain generates your seed phrase, the name of your wallet, and when you send to the account of the creator, C-R-U-A-C, these UNTB tokens, 249 or 250, depending on the price of RAM memory. And your memo, that is the name of your wallet, what you created, or you can take the one suggested by blockchain. And within 1 hour, so that the smart contract is active, you must send UNTB tokens. Therefore, please, in advance, either at the exchange by UNTBs or from peers, from partners, ask them to send to the creator account this precise number of tokens the wallet needs with the indication of the memo of your new wallet. Well, in terms of the price of the UNTB token, that's true that at the start, it was from 5 to 7 cents, whereas now I see people are impatient. They want everything mined and staked to sell very quickly and they set a price of 2 or 3 cents. And it's even good, I believe, because if we create a wallet from outside and we need 250 UNTB to create one wallet, when one token costs 1 cent, then we will pay 2.5 US dollars. And in case the token costs 2 cents, then UNTB, so it will make up 5 US dollars. If it is higher, it could be from 10 to 20 US dollars. And UNTB token should not be expensive. Otherwise, the creation of wallets will be too expensive for the people. And in future, 1 year after, when on Cryptounit blockchain there are a lot of users and the wallets are highly demanded, in future, UNTB may cost 1, 2, 3, 4 US dollars, like EOS today costs. And we will repeat the path of years, but not in 1 month. We started blockchain in February, launched exchange in March, and it takes time to repeat the historic events EOS-based blockchain went through. And so that you understand, we have the exchange wallet in EOS, and there are input and output transactions. And today, for this exchange wallet to be active, we staked in CPU, in RAM and NAT of EOS-based wallet, EOS themselves. We staked EOS so that EOS wallet is working. And the equivalent of this EOS is 100,000 euros. So look, for each wallet of the exchange to be active in RAM CPU of the wallet, we deposited 100,000 euro EOS to expand the memory. As there are transactions going on, the memory is reduced and we need to expand it. And the same applies to UNTB. The more transactions there are on the blockchain, the more demanded this token will be to expand RAM, CPU, and NAT of the wallet, or to open wallets from outside. So the fact that today it costs quite little, it's good. Good for those people who come to our blockchain and open wallets for 2.55 US dollars. So therefore, please don't panic that UNTB's token price is so low. Quite opposite, you should be excited that today you can buy this UNTB at a low price and new partners can open these wallets by paying little. Next slide, please. Well, the commission, the fees. The fee for the top up of the exchange, there is no, makes up zero, whereas the fee for the withdrawal is average, like with any other exchange. If you believe that 0.4% commission is too high, and this is equal to XMA, if you compare trading fees with Binance, so today we cannot afford these commissions as we have very small transactions. People carry out one transaction, 1-2 transaction. And at large exchanges, there are traders or they use trading bots with large amounts of trading. There, the fees will be small, whereas our exchange is at start phase only. And people, on average, carry out 1-2 transactions, and it is 0.4%. And if you believe that it is 4%, you are not correct. You do bad math. If a person sells CIU or buys CIU at 10,000 worth, he will pay only $4 as a fee for this transaction. And for the withdrawal fee, so the exchange does not earn on it. You know how high the commissions are on blockchain. In Ethereum, about $25-$30 commission. In EOS, there is no commission, and therefore we need to stake in CPU RAM of the wallet so that the fee is low. And the wallets of Cryptounit operates following the principle of EOS, and we may not actually withdraw Cryptounits to your wallets free of charge, because at the exchange there should be the provision of CIU, UNTB for staking, and therefore the trading and withdrawal fees in the near run will not change. What will change in the near run is units, limits for the minimum transactions for inbound and outbound. Here you see tariffs for verified, non-verified users. For non-verified users, no changes are expected. And the law of Estonia is very strict, and we may not accept to the exchange non-verified users. And this limit of 500 for non-verified to test, to try. And we are still in consultations with the lawyers from Estonia. They treat very strictly the process of verification of users, but the limit for non-verified will not change, whereas for verified, the maximum amount of transaction will be increased. For the time being, it is 1,000, whereas we are negotiating with lawyers and they may increase it to 5,000. What do these limits mean? These are limits for verified users for automatic top up and withdrawal. In case your transaction is smaller than 1,000, it should be processed automatically by robot, by the software. And if it exceeds 1,000, it is processed manually by AML officer. And unfortunately, Estonian AML officers work in business time from 10 to 6 p.m. And on Saturday and Sunday, manual confirmation is not done. And we've discussed it with the head of the Estonian company so that he will make a schedule of the work of his offices so that they can work even at weekends and to have additional offices to work extra time so that manual confirmation is 24/7. But unfortunately, in Europe, not every AML officer is ready to work at night. We know this problem and we try to address it or find AML officers who will work remotely in other countries of the world, maybe Colombia, Australia. For them, it will be daytime, whereas for Estonian exchange, it will be nighttime. And I believe that within the next week, we plan to resolve this issue as well. People are asking how to become a specialized VIP, special VIP client. A person cannot become the VIP client, only the legal entity. If this entity issues Cryptounit-based token or lists its coins at the exchange. So individuals cannot actually, these tariffs do not apply to individuals.
Well, as far as the stake in CRU for CRU is concerned, I have told you about it already. Yes, there were quite a few technical errors on our exchange, and many automatic deposits and withdrawals didn't really go through because there was a serious bug, as we call it. The exchange couldn't calculate the Cryptounit to Bitcoin exchange and other things. There is a currency converter in there. If a person put for withdrawal 0.017 Bitcoins, the exchange thought it was $0.70, which is below $50 minimum. And those operations did not go through automatically. Operators had to confirm them manually. So this error has been rectified this week on Friday. And I think today already there will be automatic withdrawal of money and it should be up and running. Let's move on to the next slide. Yes, dear ladies and gentlemen, we did have a summit, but unfortunately in Dubai, they haven't yet adopted the law on cryptocurrency. And that's why they didn't allow me to show the slides that I wanted to show you at the summit. So today we're going to show you those slides, the slides that we prepared for Dubai, but it couldn't show. Yes, guys, we wanted to tell the entire audience at our summit the history of Cryptounit development. But I know that you, dear partners, are always following our webinars and summary webinars and know what kind of work has been done so far, that we had a tender, that bidding procedure, that we developed our loan blockchain. We all have wallets, those of us who wanted to have it. We launched the exchange. We have staking as well. And on the 10th of February this year, the World CRU token sale was launched by the company called UGPay Group AG, a Swiss company registered in the SEC. And many people are asking how to present Cryptounit program, what we should offer to people when the CRU token is traded at 10 cents at the exchange, while World CRU is offered by the company at 40, 50 cents. Very soon, it's going to be even a dollar. Then I would like to clarify here. CRU tokens were bonus points when purchasing EIPs, educational information packages from the Academy of Private Investing. You never bought CRU tokens from the company. You were purchasing education, and CRU token points were given to you as a bonus, as a gift. And those people who received quite a lot of tokens, also under the marketing plan and as a gift from the company, they are ready today to sell their tokens even for 10 cents because they received them for free. Let's be honest here. Whereas World CRU tokens are security tokens officially sold by UGPay Group company. And in the near future, there will be a possibility to convert CRU to World CRU. And the fact that CRU token today, utility token, costs that cheap, this is cool. This is an opportunity for those people who weren't able to join Cryptounit program in 2019, 2020, when the token point was quite cheap. And now they can buy them cheap at the exchange, well, cheapish at the exchange, and then convert them into World CRU. But very, very soon, we are going to run out of unlocked CRUs. At the exchange, we have 10, 15 unlocked CRUs in trading. And the price being so low right now is a temporary thing. And not all of the people can do big deposits on the exchange because of the limits and inability to get verified. But I think in April, all the issues will be addressed and people who buy CRU tokens at the exchange will be able to stake them for UNTB or convert them into World CRU. And World CRU is sold by the UGPay company, as you know, at a completely different price. So it is very profitable to buy World CRU tokens and then convert them into World CRU. And we will continue our advertising campaign, our promotion campaign, and do public awareness raising, press releases explaining the value of our token. And I think gradually, over 3-4 months, the entire global community will know, will recognize the value behind our tokens and what kind of opportunities they offer. Yes, CRU token right now is not appreciated enough. At the summary closed webinar, Andrey will show you the real value, or better, what should be the real value of the CRU token, depending on our investing portfolio, investment portfolio, because our investment token is worth 11 billion with only 20 million CRU on the exchange, which means that the CRU price should be at least $1,000. Yet now it is 10 cents only, because we have quite a lot of partners who received a lot of CRU points in March, April 2019 for free, and they do not really appreciate that gift. And they are ready to literally squander that gift and dump it at any price. Let's move on to the next slide. I guess we have to click on the presentation several times to see all the all the milestones here. In April, we're going to work real hard on the exchange. We will be improving the functionality and the operability of the exchange. We are staffing the exchange as well. But you know, since it's a legal exchange, every employee needs to have a special diploma or a certificate or financial education, or they need to take AML courses and KYC courses. And preliminary, I can tell you that on the 6th of April, we are planning to launch the whole conversion from CRU to World CRU. Yesterday, I personally tested this functionality all day long, how to exchange or convert CRU to World CRU. What you need to have is you need to have USDU on your balance. And depending on how many CRUs you have to convert, you will have to pay a certain number of USDUs. So the reason why it's on the 5th of April and not or 6th of April and not the 5th of April, because the 5th of April in Europe is a day off. Well, usually, you know, in Russia, they celebrate Easter only on Sunday, whereas in Europe, it's 2 days, both Sunday and Monday. So we can imagine what kind of a load that will be on the exchange when the conversion from CRU into World CRU will appear. All our partners will run to the exchange and try to convert it. I will try to record the video instructions how to do that conversion. Well, and the bad news here is that when I tested the conversion from CRU to World CRU, I noticed that the smart contract splits all frozen items into separate transactions. Originally, we thought that this commission for the exchange of CRU into World CRU will be charged only once, $1, $2, I don't know, $10. But the smart contract cannot unite all frozen items and charge you only once. So if a person bought educational packages only once and they have only one frozen item, then yes, they will pay just $1 of commission. But if a person bought packages in installments and they have 10 frozen items, thankfully, tokens from the back office that were accrued under the marketing plan were accrued only once a month. So we have only 24 frozen items. that are older than for 545 days. So we will have to pay $24 tops for the gift CRUs under the marketing plan. So I was kind of upset, and I think there will be a lot of partners complaining. So in other words, you will be able to convert all of your CRUs into world CRUs, but not in one go, or it may be in one go, but you will be charged the commission several times. And it is entirely correct for the accounting purposes for the Swiss company, because every conversion from CRU to world CRU, those USDUs that you pay as a commission will go to the wallet of the UGPay group on blockchain. And that's how they're going to report to the Securities and Exchange Commission that the world CRU tokens were released and money was paid for them. So please understand that we won't be able to rewrite the smart contract, that if you have 10 frozen items, you will have to pay for each transaction $1 or $2. I don't think it's a huge deal for the opportunity that the company gave to all of the partners. And it's going to happen on the 6th of April. You will have that option to exchange your CRUs into world CRUs and then stake your world CRUs for UNTBs. So this is as far as our future plans are concerned. Then there will be an exchange. First, we're going to have CRU into world CRU converted. And then we're going to have the synchronization of the UGPay group back office with the blockchain for the world CRU tokens. Then later, maybe in April, we will add the fiat exchange, fiat to crypto exchange gateway inside the wallet itself. The developers have this task. And of course, for May, we also plan to upgrade our wallet. The wallet that you can see on the blockchain today, we will still have to work with it for several months, because I know a lot of people are complaining that you have to enter your seed phrase all the time. It's not entirely safe. We will be negotiating with the Trezor company in order to make sure that blockchain tokens are integrated in the Trezor or like Scatter and other wallets that you guys are probably got used to. So this will be an application that will be storing your private key. It's like a cold wallet, and you will just confirm it with your password or a PIN code, your transactions. And so in other words, we will improve our crypto wallet in May. In June, we will have negotiations. Well, negotiations are already being conducted with additional exchanges for us to be able to list our CRUs, UNTBs, and USDUs on coin market cap. So that first we have them listed on several exchanges, and then they will be included in coin market cap. And then in July, we'll have other projects developed on blockchain, like the legal guarantee, digital guarantees, policies, and so on, Ugain, and so on and so forth. So we will be improving the functionality of the blockchain, and only then we will be issuing new tokens on our blockchain. So exchange updates in 2021. I already told you that we have been staffing our exchange personnel in order to be able to work 24/7. We will have a ticket system. For now, you're writing messages to the email address, and of course, you receive your automatic response, like, thank you very much, your message has been received, but the support service cannot cope with so many letters, like 300 letters a day. Therefore, we asked our developers to develop the ticket system. You go to the back office of the exchange, and inside the back office, you can submit your question, your request, and then wait for the answer from the support. Some of the partners are asking what kind of exchanges we are negotiating with for the listing, and I won't disclose the names until we sign the cooperation agreement. You must understand that this kind of information is quite sensitive, and while the negotiations are ongoing, we cannot really disclose that information. Also, we will improve the equity capital for the exchange to be able to support the increased trading when the first unlocking of the World CRU happens. Quite a lot of legal work will be done. Also, the exchange interface will be reworked to bring it to the level of Coinbase. So the functionality that you can see right now is a little bit complex, and a lot of people asked for a simple exchange functionality, the way it is on Coinbase, buy sell without any charts and complex orders, this simple, the basic functionality. The developers have received that task, and it will need maybe several months for this simple functionality for the exchange to be rolled out. Also, additional currency pairs will be added. ERC20 functionalities will be added. Tron Cosmos tokens will be added. Everything will be added this year, and more gradually the exchange will get the looks of a good, genuine exchange. For now, we have small volumes, small money rotating, circulating in it, and I'm still working on some troubleshooting. So guys, I'm just asking for your patience. For the exchange to be working ideally, smoothly, I think we need two months. We need to have a 24/7 support staff. Then we need all the technical issues to be addressed, but at least 2 months is needed for that. Over here, I wanted to draw your attention to what cryptocurrency capitalization is. Many partners who are selling, when we're preparing the slides, when we had our CRU token was 20 cents and UNTB was 6 cents. And many partners who are selling CRU tokens at 10 cents, they do not really understand what place our token has taken in the world rating. As soon as we are on the coin market cap with our capitalization, we have 34.5 billion coins in circulation, CRU coins, which amounts to almost 7 billion capitalization. So we, in terms of capitalization, we are even higher than EOS. And we created the biggest fork in the history of EOS. EOS itself has 2.5 million accounts in 4 years. Our blockchain has been in existence for just 1 month, and we already have 900,000 accounts. Nobody did a bigger fork of EOS than us. And I would like to congratulate you all on this. And you need to just be appreciative of our promises, of what is in store for us. Only we, for now, know about our project. Those who attend our webinars, those who participated in the project for the last 2 years. But when the entire world learns about our project, we will, you know, fly to the moon. So that's why it says here, buckle up, we're taking off. And I think this is it from me. This is what I wanted to tell you today. Please come to our closed meeting, if you qualify for it, next Saturday, and Andrey will give you more detailed inside information on the potential cost of CRU and World CRU, and see you later.
Thank you very much, Maria. You must agree, this is impressive. And dear partners, this is just the beginning. Maria has just told us that this is the very beginning of our journey, and we will reach the moon, I'm sure. Thank you very much for that news, Maria, and for improving everything every day. And I think the plans are indeed out of this world. And let's attend all the webinars and be updated. And before we go to a small break, we have one more section, which is dedicated to the project called Global Unit Pay, which is our payment system. It is very important to be aware of what's going on in this system, about the verification and other details. And the next speaker is yet another maestro in the topic of blockchain. One more slide, please. One more slide in English. Maestro's name is Marshall Neon Zima. Hopefully I did not torture his name. One day I'm sure I will learn how to pronounce all of our partners' names, because we have so many countries represented. He is also, I'm sure, the bringer of good news and exciting news, as is Maria. Marshall is the member of the Ambassadors Council, vice president of under the Consumer Community Affiliate Program, Evorich. He's a blockchain enthusiast, has a master's degree in computer sciences. He's an entrepreneur and a speaker. So Marshall, I had the biggest honor to be participating with you in MLCI Marathon 260. And it is thanks to you that I learned so many important things and learned how to learn dedication to this project from you. And Marshall, I'm giving you the floor.
Hi. Good afternoon. Good morning. Can you see me? And can you hear me properly? So let's check the sound first, because I'm in a place where I might not get the best sounds. Okay, great. So you can hear me nicely. Thank you very much, Valeria. It's a pleasure to see you. And thanks a lot for the previous speakers. What a great news that we're receiving. We're making progress. And I can tell you where we are with the blockchain is just the beginning, like Maria just said, because if you had experienced in 2017 Binance, how it was, and when you look where they are now, you know that we will be very far. Okay, so in my part today, I'm going to share with you the progress of what we managed to achieve in the Global Unit Pay. So if we can move to the next slide, please. If we move to the next slide in all languages. Okay, great. So let me just give you some statistic on what happened with our Global Unit Pay. We had about 40,032 total registration, and about 19,003 who were verified. We're no problem. And we still have about 298 people who are waiting for verification. Okay. And the registered accounts, which have created their accounts with the Global Unit Pay, but have not yet uploaded documents, so which I would plead with you, who, if you have, some people have registered, but they did not upload the document. But in their opinion, they have uploaded the documents. So please double check your account, because I spoke to a few people last week, who they thought 100% they have uploaded their document, and they will say that they've been waiting for 6 weeks, 2 months without being verified. And when I actually checked on one-to-one, they have not uploaded their document at all. So please make sure you double check. We have a big number of people who have registered but have not uploaded any document at all, and they think that the account has not been verified, has been delayed, etc., etc. So please check. If you haven't heard from the company from an email whether you have been declined or verified, please check your back office or Global Unit Pay to make sure that you have uploaded your documents. Okay, so 19,254 people, it's quite a lot of people have not uploaded documents, but I can bet a big number of these people, they think they have uploaded the documents. Okay, and we also had about 1,477 people were rejected for different reasons. And if you can have a look again and see if you have an option to re-upload your document. Now, this was on the Global Unit page. Let's talk about the Global Pass. Okay, the company which you deal with the verification, check your passport and ID. So a total number of 19,321 were accepted, and a big number of 21,932 were rejected. So either because the number of the passport is not very clear, or for whatever different reason, or the passport is expired of ID. Okay, so let's have a look. Let's look at the next slide. Let's go to the next slide. Can you still me here? Can you still see me? And because I can't see myself or hear me as well, just put a plus if you can. Okay, brilliant, great, thanks. Okay, so now the card update. So in Moscow office, they have received as part of the check to make sure that everything is working fine. Two gold cards has been received at Moscow office, and two blue cards with the normal. Like the normal one is the one at the bottom, and the gold card is the one at the top. And this one has been received and has been used. They're working properly. Before we going to start the launch to start the delivery of all that big bulk of cards. Okay, but I'm going to tell you at the moment, they're going to start with the European Union and the UK for the rollout at the beginning. Okay, and this is it's not just unique to us. If you look at many payment processes, they start like that, because there are some regulation they have to go through cooperating with different countries. And the good news that we have added a new team members on our project, who's going to be the assistant of this project, his name is Aiden Ward. So congratulations to him for going through all these for all the recruitment process that done. All the received a lot of applicants, which was great news to see that people are willing to come to help the company. They're willing to participate. Again, if you see any advertisement of any role within our company with different projects that might be around, please do apply. If you think you have the skill, apply, because the customer support is looking for people in Unitex, in Global UniPay, and also there have been some recruitment of a team as well within our Global UniPay. So if we move to the next slide, please. I think this is pretty much my last slide. So the good news, guys, is that so the team is growing. Even though you see the staff is not going according to quickly how you expect it, just be a little bit patient. If you look at where we came from, 2019, the start of the program, and where we are now, it's quite a lot of step. And I congratulate all those people who are leading this project, especially Maria and all the other project managers. They're carrying a lot of weight, and the achievement that happened is quite a lot. So please bear with them and understand that where we are is just the beginning. Just watch out for the future. And don't panic. Don't be the last person who sold their crypto at the early stage, thinking they don't have any value, they don't have any usability of it. You might be asking yourself, okay, now with the crew, I can't buy anything. but in the future you might be able to do something. So don't lose hope, just be patient. You have been patient enough already. So I wish you have a great day, a great afternoon, and a happy Easter for those who celebrate it. And I'm going to pass back to Valerie. And so, yes, have a nice weekend. Bye, everybody.
Thank you, Marshall. Thanks a lot for your update. Well, dear partners, we have a 10-minute break. In Colombia, it's 8:30 in the morning, the time to enjoy your cup of coffee. I believe our partners should revitalize their strength, and we'll see you in 10 minutes. Enjoy your time.
Let's go. Thank you.
Well, after your well-deserved rest, hopefully you managed to have a cup of coffee or a glass of water. Let's move on to the fifth item on our agenda. You all know that the Association Generals of the World for Peace is the one that tries to create peace and stable world for everyone. And this future is built together. And today, please welcome Anatoly Skargin to share the news. He is an active Evorich member, trainee of the private of the Academy of Private Investor, a peacekeeper with 10 years experience. He is the president of the International Public Association Generals of the World for Peace and the major general of the militia. So please welcome Anatoly Skargin. This is our regular sound check. Please give me some indication of how well you can hear me. Is it fine now? Can you see me as well? Yes, we can. Is the sound clear? Firstly, my video was not active, but most importantly, you can hear me. Well, good afternoon, dear friends. I'm very thankful to the organizers of this webinar for the chance to convey our voices to the millions of the new participants. And in particular, Valeria Ravelo, our host. She is stunning and kind-hearted to host today's conference. Actually, I've been thinking a lot, how should I structure my speech in 8 minutes to focus your attention on the significance of peacemaking activities? I don't want to repeat the information at the previous conferences, but remind you that in 2019, almost $2 trillion US dollars was spent on the weapons, and 10.5 million were killed in wars after the Second World War. Simply think it over, 300 kids daily. We cannot keep silent. When your relative dies, this is a tragedy. But when many people die, this is statistics which people in treat indifferently until this grief comes to their homes. And at present, there are crises all over the world, if you follow the news. And our task is not to find who is to blame, where's to find the solution to these problems. And I want to call upon you saying that solution we offer is right. If we blame our governments and people and those who actually have the financial capital concentrated, if we support them, then with our blood, we will pay this price. There was the First, the Second World Wars. There are ongoing military conflicts. And the figures I gave you at the beginning means that we are at the borderline. And you know that the heads of the nuclear states cannot come to an agreement. People have the only way out, and we have the only chance to apply, and that is to bring nations together for the sake of peace and friendship on the planet by using new communication technologies. We didn't have these opportunities before, and therefore nations were not united. We've been running this program for 9 years, And throughout these 9 years, we constructed a solid foundation based on which we can build our common house. How and what to build, we know it. And now our task is to open new sections and using these arrangements actually to create our mosaic of relations. The time is limited, and our task is to use those possibilities we have. Today, the forces of evil and good are in the forefront, and we are reaching the culmination point. The energy of light, of life, provides for ideal conditions for the development of spiritual, and there couldn't be happiness in your life, in your soul, in your family without harmony. I understand that many people of business, so they don't develop spiritually and they value only tangible assets, but this could lead to the liquidation of the mankind. Even the Lord does not force us, but suggests some choice to live in harmony or love, or with hatred and evil in our souls. We are to choose. And I'd like to note the unique idea of new, which according to the idea of Andrey Khovratov should change the paradigm and develop the economic relations with the mankind face. And that was actually the main idea of our signing the agreement 2 years ago in Almaty. The path of the new and the association Generals of the World for Peace makes us progress forward while overcoming impediments. The mankind before has never had such a program and even was scared to think that we can change the principles of the development of the mankind. But I want to stress your attention and say that this is the only possibility to take the hand of the energy of life, of the light, and the so-called absolute light or absolute love. I understand that not everyone may understand what I'm talking about, but according to the laws of the development of the spiritual world, we need only 1% of intelligent people who energetically will create the co-organization of the society, of the community. And we have our own bright example, a person who in his mind created the philosophy of new, and he actually energizes other with this idea. And the same happens in the society of restructuring. Today, we have two national sections in India and Czech Republic. Peacemaking is not an administrative role. This should be a calling of your heart, your desire to love people, to love nature, to love the earth. And for India, we need only to bring together 1% of people, train them, and the restructuring of society will be done. And this way, we can restructure every country and the humankind on our earth. And we should find other nations who actually cannot live this life without love and peace. Like we actually found Dr. Lydia in India, who in Minsk told me, I want to establish our Indian national section. And it today is prosperous. I believe you saw the news, how active they are. And I'm sure that they will definitely embrace 1% of their population under the flag of peace and good. You can ask me whether tangible assets are an important part. Yes, they are. But as said before, if we develop them in harmony, if even for a second you feel this state of happiness, you understand me, and you will not compromise it with anything else. And therefore, the principle for well-being of everyone, we need peace, health, and material well-being. when we establish the national section, only $3 is go to the headquarters of the association, whereas all the other membership fees are for the purposes of the national section so that they develop quickly and actively. Peacemaking activities do not prevent the development of business programs, but only contribute to their development and support them. And we've been cooperating for over 2 years, but a long distance has been covered. Quite recently, there was a video made up on those activities and mutual areas we cooperate with. To learn more about us, we should have at least 3-hour video to explain in detail who we are, what we do. There are lessons created, translated into English, and in the near future, we will make short videos on each of the areas of our activities. And it was due mostly to NEEW. And we actually started the project called the DAF of the World, of the Peace. We developed the strategy. We created an eye-catching booklet or leaflet, and the relevant letter is submitted to the senior management of one of the 5 great states. And today, the documents are submitted to the government of that country for their consideration. And our task is to structure one project, and the UN general will be invited and other heads of the states. In the future, we plan to expand and roll out this project to other nations where the national sections will be opened. And on the walls, the project is called the Wall of the Peace. And on the Wall of the Peace, there will be the people who actually contributed to peacemaking. And it will be even more powerful than the Nobel Prize, Nobel Committee. So, but it does not mean that we won't work with them. We will do it, and every peacekeeper can actually keep the memories of his name in 175 countries. 100,000 billionaires who already died, most of them are forgotten, but Teresa, mother of Teresa, is remembered in all the countries, and her picture will be on our wall, number one. But we have other motivational opportunities. We haven't awarded anyone with our order. Only one person enjoys the title of the General of Peacemaking, and that is Andrey Khovratov. And I believe you enjoyed this award ceremony in New Delhi. And we have only one ambassador. We still have no people's artist. And these are all our motivational capacities. And when we reveal all of them, many people will be breathless and proud of being a part of peacemaking. I call indifferent people to start thinking, particularly those who have children. We have a chance to preserve, protect our planet, future for our future generations. And you know, I have the title of the Major General. The host announced it. And there is a title called the General Millionaire because I am an active partner of Evorich company and I'm called an investor. So then as soon as I become a millionaire, my title will sound even better. Not the Major General, but the Millionaire General. And I believe this is the white path, as in Asia they call the people who do peacemaking. And I make an order to award Yulia Bulatova with a medal for mercy, for strengthening peace, friendship, and mutual cooperation between all the countries and nations of our community. Thank you for your attention. Namaste, my friends from India. Thank you very much. Wow. Millionaire general. It is something fascinating. We congratulate Yulia. We know that you are a great girl doing a lot of good things. But after this news, we have some other news to share with you. How our new how it penetrates business, the opportunity to create new sources of income, new community, and the message that should be in our hearts and should be duplicated. And this way, we can much quickly build new around the world. Well, next item on our agenda is the project Genius of Finance. And this is what our CEO calls the simulator. And we have the next speaker who will tell you about it. Valeria Leonova, she is the manager of the project Genius of Finance. She is the participant of the MLCI Marathon 260, and she will keep us informed about the updates of the Genius of Finance and what to expect ahead. Valeria, the floor is yours.
Hello, everyone. Let's check our sound and video. So yes, Valeria, we can hear you. I cannot turn on my video. The system tells me you cannot turn on video because it has been stopped by the host. Well, I can start without the video. Try turning it on right now. Yes, thank you. Hello. And my name is Valeria Leonova. And today I'm going to tell you the updates on the Genius of Finance and the plans for the next month. Could you please switch to the next slide? Yeah, thank you. So from the day one of the sales, quite a lot of copies have been sold at a discount. And at the moment, the possibility for purchasing the training at 350 units with the courses on financial literacy is open only for the VIP club members. Also, you can purchase the host courses for 1,000 units, and the promo for 260 is over, and the next one will be announced only after the approval by Andrey Khovratov. Out of 100 qualified hosts, only 30% used the opportunity to upgrade their qualification and receive a 90% discount, whereas the remaining host did not take on this opportunity. And it's a wonderful opportunity, and I don't know why people didn't do it. Also, on numerous requests of the prize winners of MLCI Marathon and GoPro, Andrey approved the discount, and you can buy the host course with 35% discount. And discount is available only to prize winners within MLCI Marathon and GoPro. As for the courses, we have finished the recording of the videos. They have been translated into various languages, and textbooks are being prepared and translated. And as soon as they are translated, our partners will get the access to those courses. We will give you access to our new platform, and those who bought the certified host course will be the first tester, will be the first testers of our new training platform of the Academy of Private Investing. And the access will be consecutive, gradual. Every 3 days, you will get access to the next step. After the assignment, home assignment, and the notes on your realizations. So you get access to the next level if you meet certain conditions. Some of the lessons will have homework following it. For example, calculating your income and expenditures, balances, taxation, and so on. We have a test consisting of 55 languages. It has been translated into all our languages, and host certificates were developed. And those who have a score of more than 55% will receive those certificates. After the restrictions are lifted, I think you know what restrictions I'm talking about, those related to the epidemiological situation. Hosts will be able to prepare their teams for the participation in the international tournaments with a prize pool. You will be able to see on the website how the landing page looks like. In February, we started doing the marketing involving the creating of the website and the landing page. In our API back office, in the section instruments, there will be three landings on Genius of Finance. The first one is buy yourself a box. And you can use your referral link and send it to the people who can buy it. So it's our selling landing page to buy the box version. And the second one is the play with the presenter or the host, game master. And in all the cities where we have the hosts or purchasers or people, buyers of the game, you will be able to get in touch with those people, and they not necessarily have to be a certified host, and play a game with them. And then the next one is the creation of personalized landing pages. In other words, we are ready to provide each certified host with their own landing page. In other words, the company will bring people to you. So you completed the courses and the company is sure that you are qualified. The company will bring people to the address that you give it. So you pay your courses, and then those courses will pay off in quite a short period of time. Also, we upgrade the online version. At the first stage, an independent audit will check what has been done so far and see if it fits the rules. And after that, we will agree on the timeline for the troubleshooting. Next slide, please. So this is the list of people who bought the game and did not provide a delivery address. People, dear partners, here are your names. We cannot reach you either by phone or email. The support is writing to you and you don't reply. So you have not filled in your address. And we are ready to ship the game, but we don't know where to. So this is my request to all of you. And if you're watching this slide and you know those people, tell them please that we are looking for them. We have more than 300 people who bought the game and 40 of them simply got lost. So if you know those people, please tell them to provide their address to our support service. And the support service will send that info to me and we will send the game on that very day. Please help us out, because people think that they bought the game and the company does not send them the game. We can't do that because we don't have the delivery address and your feedback. And to recap, so what do we have in our plans? We would like to give you access to our lessons, which will be, as I said, gradually opening. For you to get your own landing page, you need to provide certain information, what city, at what address you live, and when you are ready to host games, what experience you have in hosting your games. Maybe you can provide pictures from your trainings. You need to set up your page and provide some materials as well, maybe a personal photo. And based on that information on your form, we will develop your own landing page. And also we promise to renew or put back our Genius of Finance webinars. And I guess this is all the information that I wanted to share with you. Thank you for your attention and see you later. Thank you very much, Valeria. Indeed, very wonderful news that we've just heard. And I think our training, the Genius of Finance, is quite a source for professional and personal development. And I hope you realize that. Very good that we update our information, our knowledge, and we will do our best in order to make sure that those trainings are held in each country, each city and town, for us to get together in groups and practice, put our knowledge into practice. So let's now, I guess, listen to the monthly report from the project manager of EduCafe. This is yet another project that is going to bring us income, and a project that has been rolled out in several countries now and will be rolled out even more countries. And our next speaker is as I said, the project manager, Anastasia Kazhevnikova. Anastasia is the manager of the EduCafe project. And in addition to the news about this project, Anastasia will tell us about the plans for the near future and what stage we are at right now. Anastasia, I'm passing you the floor. Thank you very much for the introduction. Let's check the sound and the video. I think everything is okay. And I'm glad to welcome all of our partners and all of our friends. Thank you very much, my beloved colleagues, for the presentations that you did on your projects and products. And I was very surprised to see Anatoly Skargin. It was quite a surprise, very pleasant surprise. So my best regards to you. We had a conversation not so long ago before our webinar. He wished me the best of luck, and unfortunately I couldn't wish him the best of luck too, but nevertheless I was pleased to see him and listen to him. And Valeria is also a colleague of mine, and we work shoulder to shoulder and can see how magnificent our projects are. And now I would like to ask you, dear partners, who at the moment has experience, or better, who has joined us some time ago? I mean, who has a lot of experience in working in all of our projects? Basically, in other words, I would like to see our old timers here and see how many we have of them. And you decide yourself whether the experience that you have in our company is extensive or not. Thank you very much. And also I would like to greet our new partners, our new leaders, potentially very cool speakers in the future, and join all of our projects and offers, and don't hesitate. Let's lit this planet up together. And, you know, I always like to have those kind of pep talks, you know, in order to bring ourselves to the necessary level of excitement. And let's start with the EduCafe presentation. I guess this is one of my favorite projects so far. Please change the slides. And let's take a look at the video.
Allo Cafe breaks the traditional understanding of running a restaurant business. Our restaurant chain was developed in partnership with the Academy of Private Investors, an educational project on finance and investing. Our menu offers a great variety of dishes, and absolutely everyone can find something to their taste. Our chain boasts the following functional features based on the fast and tasty philosophy: cleanliness, hospitality, accuracy, working equipment, high-quality products, excellent customer service. First, in the educational cafe, you can successfully hold a business meeting, negotiations, you can network, or simply have a nice meal. You can also order food delivery to your home. We keep in mind the main idea: a client is already hungry, so we always give our best. Third, in sidewalk cafes, you can have a balanced and high-quality meal without spending a minute longer than you need. There is a special training section in educational cafes where students of the Academy of Private Investors can meet their new partners, share their experience and skills. These are our most loyal customers. By investing in EduCafe, you receive a wide range of bonuses, from guaranteed high profits to pleasant bonuses when visiting a cafe. Your partners will thank you. By the way, visitors are also entitled to a nice bonus, a free lesson in our academy on the house. You will learn what international crowd investing is and meet the world's best experts in this field. We provide the buyers of our franchise with tremendous opportunities to develop their own business. You can find more on our website. Join us and come again. We are waiting for you.
Thank you very, very much. Something went wrong in the other rooms. We had a different video for you too. No problem, then you will surely see the new video as well. Unfortunately, the moderator showed us the old one, but it's still a great video. And it still tells the right things about our project and has the right message. No worries. Our new partners, potential partners, saw that video and it's good. And next time we will show you the new video as well. So let's talk about the news on this project. As you know, the entire project is split into different milestones and regions. We have Russia, Kazakhstan, and Belarus. Last webinar, I told you that we are opening new cities. One of the new cities in Russia is Samara. And Samara has a lot of partners. Anastasia Yugozhinskaya is from Samara. And she's been waiting for the cafe to open up for so long. So we are opening up in Samara very, very soon. And we'll tell you later what we're going to have there in Samara. So let's talk about Russia here. And by the way, again, I would like to repeat what countries we have so far: Russia, Kazakhstan, and Belarus. Overall, we have four cities, which is Kazan, Almaty in Kazakhstan. Then we have Belarus, two cities, Mogilev and Minsk. And Minsk is the capital, and we have several restaurants there because the first restaurants were opened in there. So Russia. I have very good news about Russia this time around. I have things to share that I can really boast of. We have an increased number of home deliveries. We tried to set it up and we failed, and then we tried again. There were a lot of technicalities we had to overcome, and now we have an significant increase in home deliveries, we set up a smoothly running system. We're adding new and new aggregators. We do not stop on what we achieved so far. You don't have to change the slides right now, but you will see on the next slide our increased statistics. Quite a pleasant view. Then next, we have the increased recognizability of the brand, which is a standard thing. Surely, if we have increased number of deliveries, then we'll have the increased number of clients, and the recognizability of the brand will grow as well. In other words, it's brand awareness. And this is quite a must for any startup and greenfield company. Then we'll have better results in terms of wages and costs. I guess business professionals know what I mean here. In other words, is our cost to value performance has increased. So the lower your cost of production, the higher your potential revenue is. Then the biggest news I guessed today about this project is that yes, we have started building the restaurants in Samara. We can congratulate our partners in Samara and all those people who are involved in the development of that project in Samara and who helps us with the promotion and awareness raising. We are always in touch with the managers, and I would like to congratulate all of us that we have launched the construction and installation in a very, very good spot with a lot of traffic, client traffic. I haven't been there myself, but they tell me that the spot is excellent and the revenues are expected to be quite high. And hopefully the partners who will go there will enjoy their time. Please share your feedback with us. It is very important for us. And then another good piece of news, quite a magnificent too, at the opening of the first restaurant in Samara, we're waiting for Harvinder Singh in May. You know Harvinder Singh, he's our president from India, and hopefully he will be able to join the grand opening of the restaurant in Samara, and it will be a very solemn opening ceremony. So let's keep our fingers crossed that everything goes well and even better than we planned it to be. As for the news for Kazakhstan, I already told you that we're changing the team in there. The project cannot be really called stable in there, but gradually, thanks to our optimization efforts, very soon, I think everything will be put on the right track and we will be simply increasing our performance, improving our performance in order not to go through any drastic changes, yet keep our eyes on the prize and for everyone to understand what the goals are and how to achieve them. We have very ambitious plans for the future, and it is very important for us to make sure that the project is like a Swiss clockwork, for us to be able to show stable performance and open new and new outlets, and not to have any random checks or inspections, because we'll know how to do and where to do it. So we'll just duplicate our experience. So as I said, we changed the team in Kazakhstan. We are now putting in place new managers, and Alicia Alexeeva, she's the project marketer, will be also in charge for Kazakhstan, and the way she's improving the overall EduCafe situation in Russia, she will do the same in Kazakhstan. And we're very grateful to her for that. Also, we closed down one restaurant in Almaty. It happens, you know. There is nothing terrible about it. that restaurant didn't perform as well as we expected it to perform. So we decided to shut it down, and we will be focusing on the performance of other restaurants. And then we'll see whether we need to shut down restaurants in one place and open up in a different location because of the rental payments or the traffic in the area, or how much a square footage costs and so on. You know that in the pandemic situation, not everything goes as smoothly as we want it to go. And there are still lockdowns that prohibit people from visiting public spaces. Therefore, we are doing our best to keep our project on float. In Belarus, we also had the change in the restaurant management. On the slide, I can't see it, but maybe you can, whether you can see other bullet points on your slide. So in addition to the change in restaurant management, which means that we changed the manager, right? So we have young, ambitious guys with already quite a lot of experience in charge there. It is very interesting to observe their work. It is quite pleasant to observe them, you know, to see how eager they are to put everything in order. So guys, if you're listening to us, thank you very much. Also, we're developing a marketing plan to promote the network, where now our marketing team develops this whole marketing plan for us to better promote our restaurants and have better revenues and grow. Also, we are redesigning the Belarusian website. There were some technical irregularities. We were buying the domain names, which is very important. And now we have to develop the website and start putting advertising. And I'm sure that we're going to have quite a huge inflow of new clients and revenues too. So this is the news about our project. I was very pleased to deliver it to you. And now let's talk about our promotion. This promotion for now is applicable to Russia only. We will have very good promotions for other countries as well in the near future. So what can we see? We have lotteries on Mondays, raffles. We need that to attract new subscribers and new clients and to increase their involvement. So what it means is that we have our social media, Instagram as well, account. We are developing at it as well. So our Instagram is called EduCafe Kazan. So please join it, follow us, like us, subscribe, and invite your friends, visit our restaurants. By the way, do have people from Kazan here? It would be very cool if you joined our promotion, which is to be held on every Monday. And as I said, it will be a raffle, like a lottery. You will make a post that you have to like, repost, and add a comment or your friends, and then you will be able to participate in the contest. And the prize is a dinner for two, like a certificate for a dinner to two, or some other bonuses from our network. So I urge you to partake and invite your guests, invite your friends. And then another prize is called dinner for a friend. So this is the promotion that aims to increase the loyalty of drivers. And you know, in all cities, we have lots of cars and people driving in their cars. And we have taxi drivers, simply car owners, and they will be passing on information about our restaurant. Like, you know, it's a standard drive in, you come in, you take your food, coffee, and then you move on. So we will think about the very cheap burger, yet tasty burger for our drivers, so that they can have a could have a bite on the way. And it will be our own like happy hours from 12 p.m. to 4 p.m. Unfortunately, I didn't add this slide here, but you remember when we had our previous chain of restaurants, on our picture we had a cat, like a big height, human height, like a poster of a cat inviting clients in, and all people wanted to take pictures with that cat and make selfies. And that cat is involved in our loyalty increasing promotion, loyalty in social networks. We will post it and we'll make our brand recognizable. As I said, it's a brand increasing promotion, brand awareness increasing promotion.
So the one who catches the cat will get a bonus certificate of our network, of our chain. And it is done frequently. So therefore, find this cat in your city of Kazan to take a picture to get some bonus, some gift. The next promotion is a 20% discount for your birthday. Thank you very much for your answering and giving the feedback. Afterwards, I will read them through. Look, 20% discount for your birthday. This is quite a popular campaign, as a person comes with his team, with his company of persons, and they learn about our restaurant and they enjoy a good bonus of 20% discount. Therefore, this campaign is win-win for the restaurant and it boosts the loyalty of our guests. There is another 15% discount for students. We developed this to engage students from the neighboring areas, including dormitories and other educational institutions, and other way to involve, to attract the young and the promising people. And you know that our cafe is not simply for eating, but for education and training. This is Edu Cafe. And you train, you learn, you may play there and invite other young participants to enroll to our project. So I believe it would be cool. And it is arranged in the following way. So they give their student card and you get a 15% discount for the menu. So I believe this is a good and beneficial possibility for the students to come and enjoy your meal and get a discount and have fun while eating a cup of tea or coffee and actually doing something on your laptop, like we all like to do it. So combining business, education, and meals. And there is another secret promotion called Kotik AK, so cat. This is a secret promotion. I will not share the details, only a few of them. If you order delivery, you can learn about the secret promotion, secret kame. So I told you about the secret promotion of the cat, but I have some data. You may be interested to find out more what is Kotik AK means or cat means. Kazan is quite similar. So, and in Kazan, in Tatar language, it is white. So Kotik AK means white cat. So here you can see the statistics for Russia as of to date, as we are dealing with Russia very profoundly and seriously. And all the other towns and countries will catch up. And I believe that these statistics will improve quite soon. And quite soon we will get full charts, and we can compare not only the restaurants, but restaurants in the countries, Russia, Belarus, and Kazakhstan, so that they don't compete, but it would be of interest to find out how we can impact each other and to see the development of our performance. Well, this time there was the basic statistics that actually reflects our project as the growing one, as improving its performance. And therefore, it was important to show what I'm going to demonstrate. So the delivery orders via Yandex Food have increased tremendously. And look, what are our indicators? Because we are replacing the managing group. I can barely see it. I will take my notes so that I see them better. Well, look, in January 2020, you know that the restaurants were launched quite recently only. So in January 2021, the delivery orders, so our profits, 1,200 Russian rubles. This is our profits in January. Then in February, there was the growth of 12,000. And due to the efforts of our marketologist and the managing group, we reached the peak of 160,000 in March. And I believe it was even higher because I was preparing my slides in advance, and therefore there was some time even to exceed this result. So therefore, please have a look. If you are excited as myself when I saw the statistics, please write down something in the chat, exclamation mark or wow. So it's great that in 1 month we had this growth of profits, and I'm sure that in the future we will have this growth trend. And you know, when we reach this peak, this bar, it would be difficult to reach it, to overcome it, but we will actually use it as our benchmark and we'll never ruin it. And we will progress and create the following statistics in other countries and cities. We'll do our best. Well, the next piece of statistics is compared to the previous period, there was 92% increase in revenues, not 5, 10%, even 10%, but 92%. And the teams of professionals are doing their job. I see that in your slide, you read the figure of 84, and it is outdated figure. But as of today, this is 92% increase in revenues. You know that these slides are prepared in advance and then they could be updated. So listen to me, I share most accurate information. So a small difference between 84 and 92, but 92 is definitely better than 84. And the next one, our searches on Yandex Maps, quite likely many partners use Yandex Maps, and I always search for some restaurants or place to go. I like Yandex Maps and don't use anything else. And there we, our searches are growing steadily from 0 to 326. This indicator is growing, and I believe that next month we will have a similar indicator in other countries. I'm very hopeful, and in Russia it will even outcome this. Well, this is our statistics. It's not the end. We plan to compete with the competitors on sites, those that are located nearby our restaurants, and we will do our best to attract our clients to our restaurants. Next slide, please. Our plans for the next month. Look, the plans are split into two categories, covering all the countries and only Russia. Because, as said before, we actually try to fine-tune the model of this business in Russia and then scale it up to others. Therefore, we will divide. Well, for all the other areas except for Kazan, we plan to bring all our regions, so to take them close to the performance in Kazan. Then our plan is to develop our own delivery service to be the local leader in the segment, in the catering sector. What does it mean? It means if we are on the Yandex delivery, then we give them some interest, some percentage of our profits. Therefore, we want to develop our own delivery service to retain all this in our pockets. As we have our partners, as we have many people, therefore we need to develop on our own. And you know that actually I was impatient and told you that the launch of the new sites, actually one site is at the process of the launch and quite soon the other one, because we are in the process of repairs there and it won't be opened in the short run, but quite soon we will open the second cafe. And here I'd like to tell you about this new restaurant. I want to learn and I want you to support me if you are our partner in Samara, if you are ready to come and support us at the launch of our restaurant in Samara, and those if in India who will support Harvinder and our restaurants in India. And I'm very hopeful that you all will be present at the launch in Samara. And I will explain why it is important, why this is a significant event for us. Because today, right now, we created conditions for development, but we have a team and we want to cheer them up as they do their best. And they left their towns of origin for 1 month and a half, and they actually develop our restaurants in other cities. And therefore, we would like to support this team when they launch the restaurant and see what is the benefits of this team. Therefore, I strongly encourage you to invite this launch event on the 1st of May, and it will be in Leningradskaya Street, the city of Samara, building 61. Please come to the launch event. The weather will be fine, and therefore let's come together to cheer up the launch of this restaurant. Later on, I will read through the chat, so please don't be modest. Let's brighten the 1st of May, our launch day. Well, the next one is Kazan. We plan to launch the website to promote this business in social media. Then registration of delivery club. This is another delivery service. Quite likely you use this service. This is the first service I tried for catering, for food delivery. I like it a lot and they take it quickly, but now we need to develop our own delivery service of our cafes, restaurants. Please do it, share your impressions with others. And it's very important for us to develop together so that we help each other. Thank you very much for doing this, if you do it right now. And there is a test run of targeted advertising in social media. including all the social media. We plan to engage all these networks, Instagram, Facebook, VK, and classmates. Therefore, we believe that there will be a boost of profits and new guests, and the feedback and communication is important as we monitor the feedback. And in Samara, it will be launched in Leningradska Street, building 61. It's important to develop, We develop our business in social media, and there will be a growth, a boost of guests. It's common when we advertise and promote ourselves. And in the end, you see, today I am actually beyond my schedule. So I don't even want to stop, but I have to, so that you can have a rest a little bit. And in the end, I want to tell you that in the chat, we read the message of our partner, Tatiana. I don't remember her last name. Quite likely, she will understand who I'm talking about, but she is very positive, trustworthy person. And in the chat, I read a very good feedback about the delivery from one of our restaurants, delivery service, good quality, quite poor quality of the delivery service. And this feedback was very useful. So we took the relevant measures to remedy the situation. And therefore, we hear all your voices and take the relevant efforts and measures to improve the process. You can perceive it in a different way. You can treat it as the criticism, but we actually treat it in an open-minded way. So we believe if we don't see some errors and mistakes, and a person shares some feedback, it's great. It's a good possibility for us to correct, to adjust, to improve, to enhance the quality so that it works in an impeccable way. And so that in the future, we can avoid it. So Tatiana, I'm very thankful to you for actually getting this to our attention. I know that the second delivery was carried out, and you get from us a bonus or a gift so that you have positive impressions from our restaurants, from our management. So I'm thankful. And now I'd like to thank all of you, my dear partners. I was very nervous as general, but as soon as I understand that this news is well awaited and you like this update, and I give my heartest regards to all those involved in this sector in our restaurants, and my regards to all our future guests and participants. So thank you very much and see you next time. Thank you. Thanks a lot, Anastasia, for the information you shared. And dear partners, if it happens in Russia, Kazakhstan, and Belarus, can you imagine what may happen if cafes are open in all our countries? We know that one of the principles of success our CEO refers to is to learn on your mistakes. And the process of education is learning on your mistakes, and we all progress to achieve our goals and to get excellent results. Thank you. Thank you very much. And for Spanish speakers, and before we end our today's webinar, let's recall the webinars that are held every Saturday. Look, this is the first Saturday, and we have the summary webinar, a webinar where we get the updates of the previous months. In this case of March, we learned the news and updates of the projects and their promotions, the financial news and blockchain news. Whereas the second Saturday is the day when we have closed webinars. There, our CEO will be present, and then we get important news of the investment department, the reports, the report on the performance of the global investment portfolio, investment appraisal, and the report of the Cryptounit program, UGP, Evorich, STO, and exclusive news of the company. It's very important to remember that the closed webinar has a link, and to get access to that webinar, you will receive this link to your email. And this webinar is accessible to consultants and above. And the 17th of April, two Saturdays after, that is a training for ambassadors or project managers for all. There, we will get some training from Evorich on leaders development. These trainings are very important, as the company offers these trainings for us to understand what this business is about and how to develop it. And on the 24th of April, that is Saturday 4, there will be a training from ambassadors or project managers for ambassadors and local leadership councils, leaders. And there we will discuss some topics for educating and developing ambassadors and the local leadership councils. As you see, in our company, we think about everyone to provide this specific, accurate information. And I'm thankful to you all for your attention, for your time. Thank you very much for your responses, for your reactions. I'm very grateful to those people who help us a lot with the interpretation and translation. I value them a lot because I believe without them, it won't be possible. We get a lot of information. So I love you all and see you at our next webinars. Bye-bye.